Hello, and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials. My name is Errol, and today I will show you how to add a payment gateway. Adding a payment gateway allows you to accept payments from your customers via credit card and/or electronic check using Method CRM. Now, I know you're excited to be paid. I know I'm super excited to be paid, but in order for this to happen, you will need a merchant account to receive payments. If you don't have a merchant account and you aren't already in the Help Center Payment Gateways article, then I suggest you go to the Help Center, look up Payment Gateways, and you will find a list of supported merchant accounts that you can get. Scrolling down, you will find a little bit of info that you need to keep in mind. Be sure to check this article so you can find any information which may pertain to you. Don't ignore it like you do license agreements. Once again, if you need to find this article, it's called Payment Gateways. You'll find it in the Help Center, and it is solution number 264. Okay, let's get started. When you have logged in, go over to the Customize tab, zoom on over to My Account tab link, and under Change My Account Settings, you will find Payment Gateways. Click View Edit, and it's this easy. Click Add New Payment Gateway. And now we can add a new payment gateway. For a credit card company, I am going to choose authorize.net because I was able to get a test account with them. Huzzah! Okay, we chose authorize.net, and now we can put in a payment gateway name. When a customer logs into the portal, they can choose how they want to pay. It can be either through e-check or through credit card. The cool thing is that Method will automatically detect the type of credit card, and so the customer won't see a drop-down menu for the type of credit card, and that might confuse them. So I am going to put in here in brackets the different types of credit cards that we accept. Great. Now for an API login ID. This I can get through my test account of authorize.net and the transaction key. Default payment method, I'm going to put to MasterCard. AR account is fine. Deposit to Bank of Banks for default. And we're set. I'm going to click Add. And our payment gateway is up. Now, of course, you can add a new payment gateway. Maybe you want to do the e-check or something like that. However, for this example, I am going to only stick to credit cards. Now to test it out. First, let's see how a customer sees it from a portal. We'll go to the Portals tab link. We will get sign in page web address and we will log in. Let's see if I remember what my password is. I don't think I do. Oh dear. Ooh, I remember. Okay, I am a customer and I've logged into the customer portal and I want to pay because I am that excited to pay you guys money. I'm going to pay the balance. And now, once they're set up, they can put in all the information so that they can give you all the money that they have, and you're going to be happy. All well and good, I'm not going to fill this out. I don't want you to see my credit card number. Let's go and see how it'll look like from the method side. Now that we're back here, I want to go over to Customers tab, Receive Payment, tab link. And now we can pay for someone. They've given us money, or at least a credit card. Who we are? Ooh, Angela Adamson owes us $1,000 almost. Payment gateway, we can choose a credit card one. It will fill all of this stuff in for us because we put them in as default. Now we can put in their cardholder name and number and we can have all sorts of fun and save an email. And we're done. That is how you set up a payment gateway. If you have any questions, by all means, just ask us in the YouTube comments or you can tweet us at MethodCRM. I hope you have a great day. Bye-bye.